How you guys doing? Chris Ignato here, and you are watching Nature Now. Maybe this video isn't as dramatic as some of my videos, but it's still incredible nonetheless. It's about a beneficial algae that's occasionally found within the egg masses of only a few species of amphibian worldwide. But the focus of this video is the amazing discovery that it can give a certain salamander the ability to photosynthesize. Check it out. For well over 100 years, we have thought that the eggs of Amblystoma maculatum, which are the spotted salamanders, have had this beneficial algae in and around the eggs, Oophila amblystomatis, occasionally found in the egg masses of wood frogs or spotted salamanders, both of which are in this video. It wasn't until the past 7 years or so that an incredible discovery has been made, and that is a photosynthetic, symbiotic relationship between the salamanders and this algae. Never before has photosynthesis been found in vertebrates. We've seen it in other invertebrates, like certain types of insects and things, and sea creatures, but never in a backboned land animal. These algae are most likely providing photosynthetic products such as carbohydrates and oxygen, not only in the eggs themselves, but also to the embryos, allowing them to grow quicker and helping them to exercise their immune system by adapting to foreign organisms instead of the typical cellular suicide found in most vertebrates when a foreign organism is within the cells. And it turns out that this algae is not just found within the cells of the embryos. In fact, it has been discovered throughout all sorts of cells in the adult bodies of the spotted salamanders. What makes this an amazing thing about spotted salamanders is the fact that other vertebrates have what is known as an adaptive immune system. That immune system will destroy other non-self biological material. This might be made possible by these salamanders by a process known as epimorphic regeneration. That is the ability to regenerate lost limbs, and that's something that's popular among salamanders and some other amphibians. That process gives their cells a level of pluripotency. In other words, cells can continue to divide and change into other cell types throughout the salamander's life. Thus, in theory, perhaps the cells of these spotted salamanders can adapt to the algae because their cells' self-recognition process, or should I say software, allows them to accommodate the cells of the algae, which is unknown in other vertebrates. To make that simpler, their cells adapt and become whatever is needed at that particular time. Now, how that algae gets into the eggs in the first place is a bit of a mystery. We have found this algae in the oviducts of the adult females of spotted salamanders, and that's where the jelly sac is formed. So it could very well start there. In fact, it's probably passed off from the parent mother to her offspring, kind of like heirloom gardening. Now, this algae doesn't move into the embryo until it starts to develop its nervous system, where the embryo starts giving off waste products like nitrates and phosphates, which is really good for the algae, and it causes the algae to bloom. As that waste is being emitted, that could be the very chance that the algae cells need to move in and embed themselves into the nervous system of the salamander embryos. This whole process comes at a bit of a cost to the algae itself. Of course, the salamander provides phosphates and nitrates to the algae, but the algae still needs some of that oxygen for itself to generate power from its food. It also needs, of course, some of its own carbohydrates. That's why it's making food in the first place. Yet the salamander uses up a lot of those carbohydrates and the oxygen. But there's also a bit of a flip side to that coin, because that algae is now kind of protected, at least in my opinion, from some of the creatures that might feed off the algae, some of the micro and macro invertebrates that love to consume algae. They can't eat the whole salamander, so it's kind of protected within that salamander, even though salamanders like to avoid sunlight. I'm sure you guys all know that. That can make photosynthesis even a bit more difficult for the algae. So for the adult salamanders, as you can imagine, this is a useful situation. But even for the embryos, this is really useful because it allows the embryos to grow much faster than their competition around them. The embryos that have this algae in their eggs and in themselves develop quicker and hatch sooner than the ones that do not. So not only do these amphibians get a jump start on the growing season by hitting those vernal pools in late winter, pretty much before all the other, you know, frogs and salamander species, they also get another advantage by hatching and growing faster than their competition and taking full advantage of that vernal pool before the sun of the warmer months dries it up. It's just an incredible symbiotic relationship between the salamanders and the algae. And when you really think about it, I'm pretty sure it benefits both organisms. Now, before I finish this video, there is one thing that can interfere with this whole process, and that is atrazine, which is kind of an herbicide used in gardening and landscaping and stuff like that. And it has been running off the landscapes and showing up in vernal pools and other waterways, which of course kills off algae. And that can interrupt this entire process. So anyways, I hope you guys found this video interesting. You know, those egg masses are filled with so much green, it's just incredible to look at. I'm sorry it's a bit more complicated, not as dramatic as some of my other videos, but it was just so cool. I had to mention it, especially after I found those egg masses just filled with algae. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. Once again, I'm Chris Ignato, signing out.
Thanks a lot for watching, and remember, if you like this video, be sure to check out this video over here that YouTube has selected specifically for you based on your watch time. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button, but you gotta click the bell icon, because if you don't, YouTube will never let you know when a new video of mine comes out. And remember, passion inspires spirit.